if I should start the class, please message us start. Students, am I audible to you? Okay, see, one more thing I want to inform you. So before starting the class, please pick up a pen and book so that you can learn the concepts by doing. Okay, parallelly I will assign you some work so that you can answer me. Okay, everyone, please take pen and at least a paper, pen and paper, or if possible pen and notebook. Okay. I hope everyone is carrying a pen and paper. Okay, so I will start the class without any delay. Okay, so to understand the concept of addressing modes, so I will explain about SFR. What is SFR? It is nothing but special function register. So how many SFRs are available? So you can see here, SFRs are special function registers. Totally 21 SFRs are available. So what are they? Here I have given the examples: A and B register, T mod register, T count register, P count register, S count register, S buff register. So totally 21 SFRs are available. Okay, and you have 32 GPRs. What is GPR? General purpose registers. So in our internal RAM structure, I hope you remembered the RAM structure. So first 32 bytes are for what? For banks. In that bank, in each and every bank will be having 8 registers, starting from R0 to R7. Okay, 8 registers in 4 banks. So totally it will constitute 32. So those 32 registers are our general purpose registers. So what is the purpose of using general purpose registers? So they are used to store the values, and they are used in programming. Okay, so if more number of general purpose registers are available, the programming becomes easy. So 21 SFRs are also used in programming, but they have some other special function. Okay, so that is defining the name here. See, so the examples are accumulator register and base register, T mod register, T count register, P count register. Okay, so what is the function of these things? T count register. So it is a timer control register. Okay, for programming the timers, we have two timers in our microcontroller. To program those things, you need TCON register. And TCON register is for power control. You have two modes in power: ideal mode and power saving mode. So to select any of these modes, you need to configure TCON register. Similarly, for serial communication, you have SCON register, serial control register for serial communication. Okay, so there are some specific purposes. Okay, some special function is available for these registers, so the name is special function registers. Okay, now I have written these instructions here. You see, move A, TCON, move A, PCON, so on. Okay, what is happening here? The contents which are available in TCON register, the contents available in TCON registers are loaded into accumulator. Okay, then you can see, okay, once again TCON will be having some individual different bits. So which bit is active, which bit is inactive, or which bit is set, or which bit is reset. You can know the status. Okay, you can know what is available in TCON by taking this thing. But that is not the matter to be discussed here. Okay, what we need to discuss here, see, for this particular instruction, move A, TCON, so one opcode will be generated. Okay, for this particular register, an opcode will be generated. Similarly, move A, PCON, it will also generate a opcode. Similarly, move A, SCON. So how many SFRs are available? Total 21 SFRs are available. For those 21, definitely you will generate 21 different opcodes. Okay, similarly for move, you are using 21 opcodes. For add, definitely you need 21 more. Okay, for subtract, definitely you will need 21. And some instructions, okay, you have numerous instructions, totally 11111 instructions are available. So if you allot 21 opcodes for each and every instruction, So total number of opcodes available in our microcontroller are 256. So that becomes insufficient. Okay. So to avoid this thing, we are using a technique. What is the technique? Instead of using this register, I am using an address. I'm assigning an address to this TCON. I'm assigning an address to PCON. Similarly to SCON and PSW. Some addresses are given. Now what happens? See here. I have given, consider the same order here. So 80, 81, 82, and similarly, I have given some random numbers. Okay. Don't consider 80 is definitely given for TCON. For example, for our consideration, I have taken this 80 as an example. Consider 80 is an address for TCON. Okay. Now, what is happening here? Mov A, 80H. The content available in this 80H will be loaded in A. Okay. Similarly, move A, 81. The content available in 81H address will be loaded into A. But what is the difference between this thing and this thing? So here, move A. Okay, for this, an opcode will be generated. Okay. The same opcode will be available, and the same opcode, only one opcode can be used for all these 21 instructions. Okay. Here, for 21 instructions, you have different 21 opcodes. But here, by assigning address, you are able to use all these 21 registers with the help of only one opcode. So indirectly, you are decreasing the number of opcodes for this. Okay. So that is okay. You are assigning the addresses. But what addresses? You will assign addresses. I have started assigning address from 81 up to FF. So why I am assigning these numbers? Okay. Our registers, accumulator register, okay, R0, R1, we have seen these registers, okay, these registers are of 8-bit capacity, okay, and we have internal RAM, external RAM, internal ROM, external ROM. Out of these, which memory is having 8-bit address? Definitely the answer is internal RAM. So internal RAM is having what capacity? What is the range? Its range is from 00 to 7F. It is constituting what? 128 bytes. Okay, the remaining thing, 80 to FF. See, you need to understand one thing very clearly here. If I am using 8 bits, that means I can allocate 256 memory locations. 256 memory locations are available. Okay, 256 memory locations are available, but purposefully, our designers of microcontroller, they have reserved only 128 bytes for RAM. And these bytes are free. So these memory locations can be, or these addresses of memory locations can be assigned to our registers. Okay, which registers? TCON, PCON, SCON, SFRs. Okay, so you are assigning this particular 80 address for our TCON. So definitely this is an example. Okay, so this is for some other register, but for our example, TCON is having 80, PCON is having 81. So I have taken these examples. Okay. So this data is, these bytes are used for internal RAM. These free bytes, okay, these addresses of these free memory locations will be used for our SFRs. So in this manner, you are decreasing the number of opcodes. Okay. That is okay. So by using addressing, you are reducing number of opcodes. Now coming to port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3. So all these ports internally having 8 lines. You have seen in your internal architecture diagram. So indirectly, these things are having what? 8 lines. That means this port is acting as a register which contains 8 bits. Okay. Okay. Actually, the 80H address is assigned for port 0. 81 is assigned for port 1, 82 is assigned for port 3. So similarly, we will see what addresses are assigned for what SFRs in detailed manner when we are dealing with SFRs in detail. But I'm highlighting only the required knowledge that is used in our addressing modes. Okay. Now see here, P0.0, P0.1, so P0.7. So these are 8 bits of registers. Using bit addressability, okay, using bit addressability, you can change the configuration. That means you can program this bit, you can set this bit, or you can reset this bit. How? Okay, if I'm using this port 0 as a byte, complete byte, so what instructions I will be using? move a comma p naught. Okay, the content available, 8 bit content available in this will be loaded into a. Okay, what is happening, see here, for this opcode will be generated. When the opcode will be generated, when this particular thing is what, move a comma p naught is written in assembly language. When you are converting this assembly language into machine language, you need opcodes. Opcodes will be generated. Okay, here opcode will be generated. If you are replacing this p naught with 80h, okay, instead of using this p naught register, if I am replacing this with 80h0, so no opcode will be generated for numbers. Okay, so this is the reason why we are using addresses instead of registers. Okay, so okay, this is for your using your port 0 as a byte or your complete register. Suppose I want to access these bits available in the registers, so what I can use, so totally 111 registers are available. We have seen in previous class 111 registers are 111 instructions are available. Out of that, 99 are byte instructions, 12 are bit instructions. So here if you are using this port in bit operation, so set B, you can use set B P 0.0. That means, so this particular bit will be set. If I am writing set B P 0.1, this particular bit will be set. Okay, so once again see here, if I am using this thing set B, for this an opcode will be generated. Set B P 0.1, for this also opcode will be generated. Similarly, 8 opcodes will be generated for set. How many bit instructions are available? Set, clear, complement. So clear, in this fashion you are having 12 instructions. So 12 into 8 for only port 0. Okay, for port 1, 8, for port 2, once again 8. That means 32 into 12 instructions. So this will be generating 32 into 12 opcodes. So once again you need to solve this problem. So what is the solution? Same solution here, instead of using this port, I will use some address here. Clear? See, but once again the same problem and the same solution. So if you are using differently, okay, set B P 0.0, 0.1, different opcodes will be generated, but we are having only 256 opcodes. Okay, I will try to replace these registers, okay, these particular bits of registers with address. So what addresses you will assign, sir? I will assign same addresses starting from 802. Once again, so in our architecture, internal structure of RAM, you have 20 to 2F, that is what bit addressable area. There you have seen 00 to 7F is allotted as bit addressable area. So I am using that particular area. Okay, continuation to that. Okay, we have next. See here, please see, concentrate here. So you have 0 to 7F. In between this internal structure of RAM, you have seen that 20 to 2F, that is bit addressable area. There you can use the byte as in terms of bits. You can give address as 00, 01, 02, up to 07 for a particular location, 2F. Similarly, now you have 80 to FF. So I can change this 80, okay, I'm changing this 80 into bits. How I am using, see here. So the 80 location, I am giving addresses 00 bit address, 01 bit address, 02 bit address. Similarly, for 81 also I am giving addresses. So now I am using this 00 address for port 0.0. Okay. Similarly, I am using 01 address for this port 0.1. So for this same set instruction, if you are having numbers here, no opcode will be generated differently. So one opcode will be generated and the same opcode can be used for all these bits. Okay, so in this fashion we are decreasing the number of opcodes. I think it is very, very clear. Okay, problem is that if register is available here, then what will happen, different opcode will be generated for all these things. To avoid that, if you are using a number here, number means address, instead of p 0.0, I am using what address, 00h. okay, 00h. So this address is assigned for port 0.0. okay, for set B, one opcode is enough and you can work on these bits. In this fashion, we are decreasing the number of opcodes by using or by assigning addresses to the registers as well as bits of the registers. Okay. Now, our topic of discussion, Okay, addressing modes. So what is addressing modes? Already we have seen this part in 8086. So basically addressing modes means how we are representing operand. So in an instruction you are having two things, opcode, first part, and operands. So how you are assigning operands, how you are defining your operands in an instruction, that is nothing but your addressing mode. Okay, see the definition. The way or the manner in which an operand is represented in a given instruction is nothing but your addressing modes. So totally how many addressing modes are available? 5 addressing modes are available. What are they? Immediate addressing mode, direct addressing mode, register addressing mode, indirect addressing mode, indexed addressing mode. Okay, so we will see all these things in detail. So first thing, immediate addressing mode. The name itself, it is very very clear that immediate data is available in the instruction. Okay, data is given in the instruction, that instructions are what? Immediate addressing mode instructions. Okay, see the example, move a comma hash 25. So this you will be coming across two different things, hash and at the rate. So what is hash, what is the purpose of hash, and what is the purpose of address? At the rate we will see here. So if any number is prefixed by hash, then that means this is, this 25 or this number is considered as data. Okay, now what will happen, see here, move a comma hash 25, that means content, okay, this 25 will be taken as data and this data will be loaded into accumulator A. Okay, move dptr hash 2000. So 2000 means this is what? 16 bit content. Okay, this is taken as data and this content should be loaded in a 16 bit register. Okay, see here, in architecture we have discussed two 16 bit registers are available. What are they? 16 bit program counter register, and second register is dptr. Program counter register is not in our control. What will happen? It will hold the address of next instruction to be accessed and it will get incremented. Okay, how you are accessing the instructions in a same pay, in the same manner, what will happen? It will increment automatically. That is not in our control. But coming to DPTR, it is the 16 bit register which is available to programmer, that means us. So you can load this 16 bit content into data pointer. Okay, so what is happening? This is considered as 2000 as data and it will be loaded into data pointer register. Okay, see here, data pointer, it is only 16 bit register available for programming, that means as. Now coming to second one, register addressing mode, it is very very clear. Once again, see, in immediate addressing mode, data is available in instruction, but here now the data is available in register. It is very clear, data will be made available in register. That is what register addressing mode. Move a comma r naught, what will happen? Contents available in a, sorry, contents available in r naught will be loaded into a. But what is happening here? We are copy pasting the data. The data available in r naught will be copied and it is pasted in a. So it is not like cut and paste. So the data will be retained by R0 until and unless a new data is written in R0. Clear? Now, second example, move R1 comma A. What will happen? Contents available in accumulator will be loaded into register 1. Okay. Now third thing, move R1 comma R0. What should happen? Contents of R0 should be loaded into R1. But this is not allowed. Okay, purposefully the designers have not allowed this instruction. So this instruction is invalid. Why? What is the reason, sir? So in textbooks they will mention only this particular reason. Okay, they will mention writing two RAM registers is not allowed in a single instruction. Okay, you can't use two registers of RAM. In internal structure we have seen R1 and R0 are the registers available in bank zero. Okay, they are available in RAM, so you can't use these two registers in a single instruction. But they in textbooks you won't find what is the reason why you are not using this instruction. Okay, I will explain the reason why. See here, move R1 comma R0. So I can use R1 as destination register and I can change the R source register. Okay, R1 remains same. I can write here R1, R2, R3, R7, right up to R7. So how many instructions are available here? 8 instructions. Okay, So for this particular instruction, one opcode will be generated. Similarly here two different registers once again, okay, R1 comma R2, okay, what will happen? Second opcode will be generated. Similarly, eight opcodes will be generated for move, starting with destination register as R1. Similarly, now coming to this thing, I am using destination register as R2. Okay, I will change this source registers. Now what will happen? For this register, opcode will be generated, that is number 9. Similarly, up to R2 comma R7. So up to this 16 opcodes will be generated. Similarly, you have how many? 4 combinations. So permutation combination, it is very very easy concept. So you can generate up to 64 different opcodes. But once again, it is a problem for us. So how to avoid these things? By using, okay, addresses instead of registers. So for that reason, okay, we are generating 64 different opcodes. So we are having only 256 opcodes. For that particular reason, we are not using this format of instruction. Okay. Suppose then the question arises, sir, if I want to transfer data from R0 register to R1, how? Answer is available here itself. Take contents of R0 into accumulator and then load the contents of accumulator into R1. I think it is very very clear. This slide is very clear. Okay. Now, direct addressing mode. Third thing is what? Direct addressing mode. So the name itself is very clear. Address is available in the instruction. Then that type of instruction comes under what? Direct addressing mode. And here I have written a note point. What is the note point? See here, this addressing mode is only for internal RAM and SFRs. Why? Since internal RAM is having 8-bit, it can handle only 8-bit addresses, and our SFRs are also of 8-bit. Okay, so for that particular reason, since these are having 8-bit addresses, we are restricting our direct addressing mode to internal RAM and SFRs itself. Okay, coming to examples, let us see what are the examples for this. Move A comma 25. See here, you need to concentrate, you need to see what is the thing here. In previous example, we have seen what? Here there is a difference. Move A comma hash 25. Hash 25 means this 25 number, it is considered as a value or it is considered as data. Okay, this particular data is taken into accumulator. Okay, you have seen here, it is very clear. Okay, coming to this example, if you are mentioning nothing here, that means this 25 will be considered as address of a memory location. Clear? It will be considered as address of a memory location. Now what will happen? The content which is available in this memory location, whose address is 25, that content will be loaded into accumulator. Okay, now see the second example, it will be very clear here. See, move A comma 30H comma A. Once again, hash is available here. No hash is available. That means this 30 is what? It is an address pointing to some memory location. Now what will happen? See, for the second example, contents of accumulator will be loaded into 30H memory location. See here, what will happen? You see, number 2, okay, contents available in accumulator will be loaded into the memory location whose address is what? 30. Okay, I will explain this point once again. See, for example 2, move 30H comma A, destination is 30H location, A is your source. So what will happen? Contents available in accumulator register, they will be loaded into memory location whose address is 30. You can see here very clearly. See, second, contents available in accumulator will be loaded into this memory location whose address is what? 30. I think it is very very clear. Now coming to third instruction, third example, move 30H comma hash 30. So what is the meaning here? You need to understand what is the difference between this 30 and this 30. So I will start with source. So this is hash 30, that means this 30 is considered as data or value. This 30, which is having nothing in prefix, so this is considered as memory, this is considered as address of a memory location. Now what will happen? You see here, content 30 will be taken as data and it will be loaded into a memory location whose address is 30. You can see here very clearly. Okay, see here, please. Number 3. So this 30 will be loaded into a memory location whose address is given as 30H. Clear? Okay. Now coming to fourth example, MOV 01H, 00H. Okay. What is source here? Source is 00H. See, I have mentioned nothing here. That means it is an address. Okay. 01 is your destination. Once again, I have mentioned nothing here. That means it is also an address. Okay. So this address is pointing a memory location, and 00H is also pointing a memory location. See, the contents available in the memory location with address 00H will be loaded into memory location whose address is 01H. Okay. You can see here number 4. What is number 4? Okay. 00H. See, 00H is a memory location whose address is 00H is an address for a memory location. Okay. And 01H is also a memory. It is also pointing to a memory location. Okay. Now, memory, you are transferring contents available in 00H memory location to 01H memory location. It is what? Memory to memory data transfer. So is it possible in our microprocessor? So this is not possible in our microprocessor. But this thing is possible in our microcontroller. Okay. Contents loaded from memory to another memory location. So this is possible in our microcontroller. Why? Because memory is internal to our microcontroller, whereas in microprocessor, memory is external to the processor chip. So because of that reason, we have discussed that memory to memory data transfer is not possible in microprocessor, whereas it is possible in our microcontroller. Clear? Now, coming to fifth example, move A, 80H. So I have used 80H. So what is 80H? This 80H address is assigned to port 0. Okay, you see here, this 80H is assigned to port 0. Why you are assigning address? So in the previous slides regarding SFRs, I have explained what, if you are using a register here instead of 80, different opcodes will be generated. To avoid that particular thing, we are using addresses. So 80, definitely this number, this address 80 is assigned for port 0, which is a SFR. Okay, what will happen here? Move A, 80H, then what will happen? The contents available in the port 0 register, that will be loaded into accumulator. Clear? Okay. I think this slide is clear. Okay. Now you have pen and paper. Okay. Now write a program here. So based on the previous modes, what we have learned about the previous modes, based on that, you please try to write the program. So what should be your program? See here, the contents available in the memory location whose address is 10H. So that content should be loaded in A. It should be your first instruction. And now the contents available in A should be loaded into R0. This should be your second instruction. Is it clear? First instruction should be contents from 10H memory location should be loaded in A. The same content should be loaded into R0. Okay. Then what you need to write? 20H contents should be loaded into accumulator, and you add the contents of accumulator with 05. What will happen in addition? The result will be once again stored in A. Now you write an instruction so that the contents available in accumulator should be loaded into 50H. Okay, you please write these things. So based on the knowledge of our three addressing modes, what we have started, so based on that, you can easily write a program for this. You please write a program, okay? That will help you. So I can understand that you are following what I am saying. Please write for this and we will verify, okay? Okay, sorry for the disturbance. I think you have written a program. So I will feel quite happy if you have written the same instructions what I'm going to display in next slide. Okay. See, once again, I will inform what I have asked you to work. So the contents from this particular memory location whose address is 10H, you need to transfer that thing into A, and then you need to transfer accumulator contents into R0. Okay, this is one part, and then you need to transfer contents of 20H into A, and then add 05 to this particular content. Result anyhow will be stored in accumulator. That thing has to be loaded into memory location whose address is 15. Okay, I hope you have written the program. See here. So what I am writing here, move A comma 10H. That means the contents available in the memory location whose address is 10 will be loaded into A. Okay, then what I have asked, same contents should be loaded into R0. So move R0 comma A. Then what I have asked, you need to load the contents available in 20H memory location into accumulator. Okay, move A comma 20H. So the contents available in this memory location will be loaded here. Then what will happen? Add A comma hash 05. So what is 05 said here? So when I have mentioned hash here, it is acting as what? Value or data. So this will be added into A, and the result will be stored in A. Now the contents available in A should be moved into memory location whose address is what? 50H. I think it is very, very clear. See, you see in the previous slide, okay? Contents available in 10H should be taken into A, then to R0, this first part. Contents of 20H into A, add 5, result will be in A. The same thing should be loaded into 50H. I have written the same thing here. Okay. Now, coming to indirect addressing mode. So we have learned about direct addressing mode. Now we are learning about indirect addressing mode. So there I have mentioned in direct addressing mode, what I have mentioned? Okay, I have written a note point. There I have mentioned that direct addressing mode, it is used for internal RAM itself. I think you have noticed this particular point. Okay, it is used for what? Internal RAM and SFRs. So here SFRs, here, see, using this ATH, I am accessing what? Port 0, which is an SFR. So I have mentioned that it is used only for internal RAM as well as SFRs. Okay. Now, this indirect addressing mode, so the name itself, it is very, very clear that address will be indirectly available in some registers. Okay. So it is used for both things. What are the both? It is used for both internal as well as external RAM. So in this you have three cases. What are the three cases? See, first thing is, okay, before going to these three cases, okay, I will explain about this first case, and I will compare between a direct addressing mode and indirect addressing mode. See here, three cases. First case, internal RAM, in that you are using 8-bit addresses. 8-bit addresses to be held by 8-bit registers. R0 and R1 are our registers used for this instruction. But we are not using R2, R3, R4, R5, R6. Why? The same reason. Okay. The same reason. Okay. If you are using R2, R3, R4, R5, you will generate different number of opcodes. To avoid that problem, we are restricting ourselves to only R0 and R1. Okay. Now, what is happening here? Second case is what? External RAM. Here you can use 16-bit address. Okay. That is carried by DPTR. I will discuss this thing. First, I will explain you this point. Here, example is move A comma at the rate R0. So here you have come across this symbol at the rate. What is the meaning here, sir? Move A comma at the rate R0 means the content which is available in a memory location. See here, the content available in a memory location whose address is available in R0. Okay. The content available in a memory location, V6 is the content available in a memory location whose address is available in R0, will be loaded into A. So what A will get what? 6 will be loaded into A. I think it is very clear. See once again, move A comma at the rate R0. That means address is available in R0. Okay. That address is pointing to some memory location. The content which is available in this memory location, whose address is carried by R0, that thing means the content will be loaded into A. So A will be loaded with what? 6. Now second example, if I take second example, move at the rate R1, what will happen? Move at the rate A, R1 comma capital A. So source is your accumulator, destination is register, but destination is not your register. So this register is carrying an address of a memory location. So what will happen? Content available A in A will be loaded into a memory location whose address is available in R1. I think this is very clear. Okay, contents of A will be loaded into a memory location whose address is available in R1. Okay, so before explaining these two cases, I will explain why you need this indirect addressing mode. Why? What is the purpose of having indirect addressing mode? Okay, suppose you have direct addressing mode, as so with that we can use addresses. So for that, to explain the importance of indirect addressing mode, I will take an example. See, these are the memory locations, starting address starting from 20H. Okay, these are the memory locations with starting address is 30. So now I want to transfer the data available in the memory location whose starting address is 20H. All these data, okay, the data 0102 up to 05, the same data I need to transfer into these memory locations. How to transfer? If you are using direct addressing mode, so what is the procedure? See, move A comma 20H means what will happen? The content available in the memory location, okay, whose address is what? 20, that will be loaded into A. What will happen? See, 20 is available. Okay, the content which is available in the memory location whose address is what? 20. This thing will be loaded into A. Okay, A is having what? 01. Now move 30H comma A, that means content available in A will be loaded into a memory location whose address is what? 30H. What will happen, sir? 01 is available in A, that 01 will be loaded into 30H. See, 01 is taken from memory location whose address is 20 into A here, and then because of second instruction, the contents of A will be loaded into a memory location whose address is pointed by 30. Similarly, for transferring to, what you need to write? Move A comma 21H. Okay, move 31 comma A. So 2 will be transferred from 21H to 31H. Similarly, you need to write move A comma 24H and move 24H. Sorry, here it should be 34H, not 24. Make small correction. Move 34H comma A. Okay, so in this way you can add, okay, sorry, in this way you can transfer these contents. So it is possible if the number of memory locations are less. If it is 5, it is okay, not a big deal. But if it is 50, then can you write 50 times? For one transfer you need 2 instructions. That means for 50 you need 100 instructions. You need to write a 100 line program for this. So instead of that thing, to avoid that thing, as an efficient programmer, what is how to become an efficient programmer? To use less number of instructions. Okay, if I am using, for the same example, if I want to transfer these contents from this particular memory location into these memory locations, now I am using indirect addressing mode. So in string instructions, we have learned about string instructions in our 8086. There we have learned using D0 auto increment, D1 auto decrement. You have transferred contents of one string to another string. Okay, I think you have you are remembering the same thing. I am taking the example, okay, using a program. Move R2 comma hash 5. So why I am taking this 5? Hash 5 means it is indicating content as value or data. So why I am taking 5? Because here I need to access 5 memory locations. Okay, second thing, move R0 comma hash 20. That means content data 20 will be loaded into R0. After getting 20 in R0, that you can use R0 content as address. Okay, move R1 comma hash 30. That means 30 is loaded into R1. Up to now it is clear. Now next instruction, move A comma at the rate R0. See, once again you need to understand what will happen when you see at the rate. That means what it is informing? The content available in a memory location whose address is available in R0 will be loaded into A. See, once again, move A comma at the rate R0. what it is informing, the content which is available in a memory location whose address is available in R0 will be loaded into A. So what is the address which is available, sir? Here R0 is having what, 20. So the content which is available in a memory location whose address is 20 will be loaded into A. What is available in 20H memory location? 01 is available. So that will be loaded into accumulator. Now what will happen? Move A comma at the rate R1 comma A. A is having what, sir? 01. Now 01 will be loaded into a memory location whose address is available in R1. So what is available in R1? 30 is available in R1. So where is this 30H memory location? Here. So what will happen, sir? The content 01 which is taken in accumulator, that accumulator content 01 will be loaded into 30H. Is it clear? Now what I will do? 01 has been transferred in accumulator and then it has been transferred to 30. What I will do? I will increment R0. That means what will happen? 20 becomes 21. Okay. Now increment R1. That means 30 becomes 31. Decrement R2. So instead of 5, it becomes 4. Jump if no 0 to test. Once again, where is the label test? Here. So once again, what will happen? 21 contents will be moved in R0. Once again, 21 content will be moved into accumulator and then into 31. Similarly, 22 content into accumulator into 32. So in this fashion, what you can do, you can transfer bulk data. Okay. So these things already we have discussed in string related instructions. I think it is very, very clear. Okay. Now, coming to second case, that is what, external RAM. So external RAM, what is the address? What is the possibility? It starts from all four zeros to all four Fs. That means it is having what, 16-bit address. And to access this 16-bit address, we have only one 16-bit register. That is what, data pointer register, DPTR. Now what is happening? See, when I am mentioning external RAM, that means it is out of microcontroller chip. So I will use the instruction move X, indicating you are getting the content from external memory. Move X A comma at the rate DPTR. So what is happening? See here, the content which is available in a memory location whose 16-bit address is available in 16-bit register DPTR. Okay. If you have understood this thing, same concept, but here it is 8-bit register, it is 16-bit register. That's not a big deal to understand. Okay. So move X is indicating what, you are carrying the data from external memory into A whose address is available in data pointer register. Okay. Similarly, move X A at the rate DPTR comma A. That means what is happening? The content which is 8-bit content available is loaded into a memory location whose 16-bit address is available in 16-bit register. That is what, DPTR. Okay, simple thing. Content available in will be loaded in a memory location whose address is available in DPTR. I think it is very clear. Now coming to third condition. Now I can access external RAM with the help of 8-bit registers. How, sir? You may get a doubt. Sir, external RAM addresses are what? 16-bit address. But you are saying that you are using 8-bit register to access that. How is it possible, sir? So for that, I will explain. Okay, this is an added feature given by our internal Intel designers. While designing this controller, they have given in this added feature. Actually, we can use only these two. We are happy with these things. But he has given a third thing. In C language, you will learn about for loop, while loop, and do while loop. But you will use for loop. But you need to learn all the possibilities. So for, in a similar way, he has given the third feature, third possibility. So what I will do is, sir, here, see. Your external RAM addresses will start from all four zeros and it will end up to all four Fs. Okay. So I will divide this in this manner. So first 00 to all zeros and the right hand side lower byte, all zeros to FF. So that means I'm not worried about these things. If I am saying, if I'm accessing 00, that means definitely it will come to this particular memory location and it will get the content from here. You may get a doubt, sir. Sir, internal RAM will also have this address 00 to 0F. So these are the internal okay, 00 to FF, these are also the addresses which are available for internal RAM. But how to differentiate, sir? See, if you want to differentiate, see the first example. You are dealing with internal RAM. What I have written, sir? Move. Move instruction is used for internal RAM. Move A comma at the rate R naught. Okay. When I am dealing with external, with this part, okay, I am mentioning what? Move X A comma at the rate R naught. Now what is happening, sir? See, the contents which are available in a register whose address is available in R naught register will be loaded into AN. Okay, it is clear. Here, because of this move X, you are understanding that this particular content, lower byte content of this location, is loaded into what? A. Okay. But are you using this third feature, third case? No, sir. We are not going to use this third case. Why? See, if you are using this third case, you can use up to 00 to FF addresses only. That means 2^8, it will generate only 256 addresses. But if I am using this 16-bit concept, second case, so all four zeros to all four Fs, that means 16-bit address. That means 2^16 is what? 64K. That means 65,536 locations can be accessed using this DPTR concept, second case. By using this third case, we are able to access only 256 locations. So which is better? Definitely, second case is better to access external RAM. Okay. So because of that reason, we will be using only first case and second case. To access internal RAM data, we will be using move A comma at the rate R naught and R1. Why you are restricted only for R1 and R naught means to reduce number of opcodes. Clear? Second thing, second case, external RAM. When I mention external, move should be followed by X. Move X should be the instruction. Okay. And you will definitely see 16-bit register, that is data pointer register. Okay. Third case is added feature, but you are not going to use this as it is serving only for 256 memory locations. Okay. Whereas our second case is serving as 65,536 bytes. Okay. Last and very important. So people don't understand this thing very clearly, but I'm going to explain you in a very clear manner. Okay. So last thing is what? Indexed addressing mode. Okay. What is the specialty here? It is used for ROM. Okay. It is used for what? ROM. Address is, okay, how the address is defined here? Okay. Address is given as sum of two registers. Okay. See here. Okay. Don't concentrate here. Listen. Indexed addressing mode is upgraded feature of indirect addressing mode. Indirect addressing mode, what you have seen? Okay, please see. Understand this button. I am going here. So indirect addressing mode, what I have said here, address will be available in a register, in a single register. Address will be available in a single register. If address is available in two registers, that becomes indexed addressing mode. See here, if address is available in, address is given as sum of two registers. Here you are using two registers to represent the address. It becomes indexed addressing mode. So what is the need, sir? What is the need of this indexed addressing mode? Okay. See, to access ROM, we need indexed addressing mode. So, okay, concentrate here. Listen. We know that ROM is also called code memory, is also called program memory. Why it is called program memory, sir? It is called program memory because we are storing some programs, predefined inbuilt programs. We are storing that kind of programs, okay, that are regularly used only for reading purpose. We are storing programs. Because we are storing programs, it is called program memory. There is another feature, okay? There is another feature that we also store static data or permanent data. Once you need to write that data and you need to read that data, okay? ROM also contains some data. Which type of data, sir? Static data or permanent data. That data is stored once and that particular data will be read many number of times, okay? So that data, how it is stored? It is stored in the form of codes, okay? The data, static data, will be stored in the form of codes. Hence, ROM is also called code memory. Clear with this thing? Why it is called code memory? in ROM, we are storing static data or permanent data in the form of codes. So because of that reason, it is called code memory. Okay. Now, so where these codes are stored, sir? These codes are stored in memory. A special part is available. That part is called lookup table. Okay. Codes. Okay. The static data or permanent data is stored in the form of codes in the ROM. So that memory location, that part is called as lookup table. See once again, lookup table is a part of ROM that will be storing static data or permanent data's codes. Okay, because of that reason, it is called code memory. Okay, now let us see what are the examples here. See, move C, that means C stands for code. So move the code A comma at the rate of A plus DPTR. So what is happening here? So what is happening here? See, the contents available in the register. Sorry, the contents available in a memory location whose address is available in A as well as in DPTR. That means the combination of this A plus DPTR. This will give you the address of a memory location, and that memory location content will be loaded into A here. Clear? See, it is very, very clear. Similar to your base indexed addressing mode in your 8086. What you will write there, sir? Base indexed address register means base address plus in some number. When you mention base, you will write some number 0506. So base address register, base register contents plus some number. You will add that thing. You will generate an effective address, and then you will transfer that content of that memory location into accumulator. See here, students, please don't get confused. It is very similar and very easy. If you have understood this concept, it is very easy. Okay, what is happening? See here, move A comma at the rate R naught. That means what is happening here? Say, speak it out. The contents which are available in a memory location. See, these are the contents available in a memory location whose address is pointed by R naught. Whose address is available in R naught. This particular content will be loaded into A. Okay, here only one register is available. If you are clear with this thing, then it becomes very easy. Instead of one register, I am using two registers to store my address, to generate effective address. Sum of this address plus this address. Okay, it becomes what? Effective address. It will point to a memory location. That memory location content will be loaded into A. Okay, so here we are having two registers, two 16-bit registers. One is DPTR, the second one is PC, program counter. So second possibility is what? Move code A comma at the rate accumulator register plus program counter register. So what will happen, sir? The content which is available in a memory location whose address is pointed out by the combination of A plus PC, that will generate an effective address of a memory location. That memory location content will be loaded into A. It is very clear and very similar to your indirect addressing mode. Okay, if you are clear with your indirect addressing mode, index addressing mode is very, very clear. Okay, now third condition, third case, move at the rate A plus DPTR comma A. So what will happen, sir? The contents available in A will be loaded into a memory location pointed out by the effective address given by A plus DPTR. So is it possible, sir? Is it possible to write some contents into ROM? So see here, what I have mentioned, sir, it is indexed addressing mode that is used for ROM. So what is the meaning of this instruction? That means you are writing the contents available into ROM. Can you write something into ROM? No, you can't write anything into ROM. So this instruction is invalid. You can't write into ROM. Clear? Now, what is the need of this indexed addressing mode? So I have said that to store some static data or permanent data in the form of codes into some special memory part of ROM. Okay, how they are stored? In the form of lookup table. Okay, so we will see what is the importance of this lookup tables. Okay, lookup table means part of ROM. Okay, it will be holding codes of seven segment display. Okay, you are aware of seven segment display. You have learned this thing, I think, in your digital electronics. Okay, seven segment display. This is available here. Names are given to each segment: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and to indicate this decimal point or point, H is optional one. So I am not using here. So if I am not using, means I am indicating it with zero. Okay. So these are my contents: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. H is not used, so it will be zero. So if I want to display zero, how I will write, sir? I need to glow this B and I need to glow this C. So what will happen? See, here two things are available: active high logic and active low logic. Active high is what? Common cathode. That means cathode is grounded. So active high logic, common cathode means active high logic. That means what is active high logic? If you want to glow any segment, then you have to supply one. What I want to glow here? I want to glow B and I want to glow C segment. So because of that reason, I will select one and one. Remaining things will be zero. So this four will give you what? Zero. It will give you what? Six. So what is the seven segment code for this one? So it is what? 06. Okay. Sorry. Similarly, if I want to glow zero, what you will select, sir? A will be selected, B will be selected, C will be selected, D will be selected, E will be selected, F. Except G, all remaining things will be glowing. And one more exemption here is what? Zero. So zero and G will be zeros. Remaining things will be one. So that segment, that will be your code for zero. Okay. See here, I am taking an example here. So I have started the same example. Okay, what example? 0400. Okay, same example here. Sorry, take this example. It is clear here. Okay, 1310 is storing the code of 0. 1311 will be storing the code of 1. Similarly, 1312 plus 3. Instead of writing 13, okay. Okay, here small mistake is, so simply, okay, don't bother about these things. So I will take this example and you will understand better. See here, what is the example here? 0400 location is carrying the code of 0. 0401 is carrying the code of 1. 0405 is carrying the code of 5. Okay, clear with this thing? So how I can write these things, sir? I can write this 0400 plus 5. 0405 can be written as 0400 plus 5. Is it okay? You can write, definitely you can write, sir. Okay, so I am trying to store this 040 address in DPTR and I am trying to store this A in accumulator. So I am using this address as sum of two registers. Clear with this thing? See, consider this example. So I am trying to store this 0400 in a register, what? DPTR. Okay, this is what it is acting as a base address. Okay, and this 5, it is acting as index, which is stored in accumulator. So here I can use DPTR as well as PC, but which one I will definitely use? I will definitely use DPTR, sir, because program counter is not in our control. Just because it is a 16-bit address the designer has given, you can use either of these things, but definitely we will use only DPTR. Suppose if I want to get a code of 5, how to get the code of 5, sir? You need 0400 plus 5. So what I will do, sir? I will move DPTR. Okay, I will write move DPTR comma hash 0400. That means what will happen? This 0400 is taken as content or data and it will be loaded into DPTR. Okay, now next thing is what? Move A comma hash 05. That means this value 05 or data will be loaded into A. Clear now? Third instruction, see, concentrate here. What I am writing? Move code A comma at the rate A plus DPTR. DPTR is having what? 0400 plus 5. So what the memory location is pointed, sir? See here, concentrate here, same thing. So 040 is available in DPTR and 5 is available in index. It is available in accumulator. So combined effect is what, sir? 0405. It is pointing to memory location which is containing code for 5. So this is what the code for 5. If you want to display 5, this is the code. So that code, the code of 05 will be loaded into A. So how to display 5, sir? Once again, I am going to see. Once again, I will take this thing, explain this thing, and I will explain what is the code of 5. Mov DPTR comma hash 0400. That means 040 content will be loaded into DPTR. Mov A comma hash 05. 5 will be loaded into A. Now, mov code A comma at the rate A plus DPTR means what is happening? See, 040 plus 5. So 0405, it is pointing to a memory location that is containing what? Code of 5. 5 tick, it is what? Code of 5. That code will be loaded into what? A. So code of 5 will be loaded into A. So what is the code of 5, sir? See, what is the code of 5? See here, if I want to display 5, what the things that, what the segments that need to glow? A should glow, F should glow, G should glow, C should glow, and D should glow. Okay, what is the code? See, right here, the same thing. So H will be definitely 0 because we are not using this. Okay, I am writing from right hand side. Okay, G is used, definitely G is used, it should be 1. Okay, F is used, sir, yes, definitely it is used 1. Okay, E is used, no, it is not used. So what you have generated? 0110 is generated here. 0110 is generated here. Now D, are you using D? No, 0 is not generated here, so it will be 0. C is used, sir? Yes, it is 1. D is used, yes, so it will be 1. So similarly, you can generate a code for this. And what is the code? If you write the code for that, then you can see 2D will be the code generated for 5. Then what will happen? 2D will be loaded into A. Clear with this thing? See, once again, I am explaining the second example. Okay, consider the same example. Move DPTR comma hash at the rate 0400. Sorry for the disturbance. Move DPTR comma hash 0400. So 0400 will be loaded in DPTR. Okay. Move A comma hash 05. 5 will be loaded in A. Now move code A comma at the rate means the code which is available in the address generated by this A and DPTR, that code available in a memory location will be, that code available in this memory location pointed out by this address will be loaded in A. You can see this thing, 0400 plus 5, command will give you an address that is pointing to a location, that code will be loaded into accumulator, code of 5 will be loaded. What is the code? It is 2DH. Okay. I think the concept is clear. If you have any doubt, please ask. Don't hesitate to ask. Okay. If you have any doubts, please ask. I'm ready to explain. You can mention in your message section. So anyone having doubts? Students, you can ask any questions. If you are not asking any question, that means you have no doubt. The concept is clear, or should I explain something? Okay. A quick revision of what we have learned, then you can pose your questions. Okay, once again I will explain what we have learned in 1 minute. Okay, so we have started with this SFR. So SFR is for what? Special function registers. So we have seen that there are 21 SFRs are available, 32 are general purpose registers. So examples are AB, TMOD, TCON, PCON, SCON. Okay, if you are using these things directly, you will be generating different opcodes, so that becomes a very big problem for us because we are left with only 256 opcodes. To avoid that, what I am doing, sir, I am assigning some addresses to these SFRs. So because of that thing, I can avoid different opcodes. Okay, next. So what addresses I can assign, sir? I can assign the addresses from 8080 to FF because these are freely available in our internal RAM. Okay, so I should not say it is available in RAM. They are available, okay? They are, memory locations are available from 00 to FF. but only 128 bytes are allocated for RAM, remaining are free. So you can use these things to assign these addresses for our SFRs. Okay, it is very clear. Next, what we have seen, so port 0 is assigned an address of 80H, okay, but internally this port is having 8 bits. I can address this port as byte addressable part. I can read it as using byte, or individually I can read the contents as bits. Okay, for that I have two methods. I can go with byte operation or byte instruction, that is what move a comma p naught. Okay, instead of writing this p naught, I am writing what 80 h, so that I can avoid opcode. Okay, this is one thing. Second thing is that I can use bit instructions to access this individual bits of port 0. Set p port 0.0. What is happening, sir, here for this also codes are generated. Once again, to avoid these codes, okay, different codes, what I will do, I will assign address for this port 0.0, port 0.1. How, sir? Now this newly available addresses are available. 80H is an address that is for, that is pointing a memory location. Internally it is having 8 bits, so that bits I am assigning addresses 0001. Similarly, I can assign up to FF. I am using this as bit addressable. Okay, I am using these addresses to indicate this port 0.0. Clear? Now we have started addressing mode. It means how we are representing our operand in instruction. That is your addressing mode. 5 are available in that. First one is what? Immediate addressing mode. That is, data is immediately available in the instruction. So how to indicate this as data? If you are prefixing hash in front of a number, that becomes data. Okay. Next thing, what we have seen, register addressing mode. So data will be available in register. In previous one, it is directly available. Now it is available in register. Move a comma r naught. Content of r naught is loaded in A. Here content will be loaded in R1. But this thing is not possible. Move r comma r1 comma r naught. This is not possible because what is the reason? You can't write two internal RAM registers in one instruction. The reason behind this is what? Once again, you are generating different number of opcodes. To avoid that, we are not using that particular instruction. Okay. Coming to direct addressing mode, what I have mentioned, address is directly available in the instruction. It is restricted. It is used only for internal RAM and SFRs. We have seen the examples. 25. Here you have mentioned nothing. That means 25 is acting as what? It is acting as address. The content available in this address will be loaded in A. Okay. Next instruction, move 30H comma A. Contents in A will be loaded into 30H memory location pointed out by this address. Okay. So I have discussed also this point. Move 01H comma 00. Both are memory locations. So memory to memory data transfer is possible in microcontroller because it is having internally, it is having the memory, whereas our processor, it is not possible because that is external to processor. Okay. One more thing we have seen, move a comma 80H. 80H is the address assigned for port 0, which is an SFR. So the content available in this port 0 will be loaded in A. Okay. So for that, I have mentioned it is used only for RAM, internal RAM as well as SFRs. Next thing, I have given how to use write the instruction for this work. Okay. Then we have started indirect addressing mode. What is the need, sir? If I want to transfer bulk data, okay, it will be a tedious job by using this direct addressing mode, whereas it is very easy by using our indirect addressing mode. So definitely I can say 97% of the programmers will use this addressing mode. Okay, this addressing mode is very often used by the programmers. Okay, we have seen in detail about this example. Then we have seen two other cases of our indirect addressing mode. What is this thing? Address will be available in register. Clear? So three ways to access this thing. Internal RAM, how you can access using 8-bit registers R0 and R1. Why you are restricting yourself to these two things? Once again, to avoid opcodes. Okay. What is happening, sir? Move a comma at the rate R0. So what is happening here? The content available in the memory location whose address is available in R0, that thing will be loaded into A. Once again, content available in a memory location pointed out by R0 register is loaded into A. Clear? Then we have seen what external RAM. External RAM is having what 16-bit address. For that, you definitely need 16-bit register. which is what DPTR, only available 16-bit register for us. So move A comma at the rate DPTR means the content available in the memory location pointed out by 16-bit register DPR will be DPTR will be loaded in A. One more feature, added feature is what, you can access external RAM using 8-bit register. How sir? So by using this starting byte, first byte is 00 up to 256 bytes you can access, but it is not a good method because we are using only 256 using this third case, whereas using second case you can access up to 65,536 bytes. Okay, addressing mode. So here it is advanced version of your indirect addressing mode. There you have used only one register to store address. Here you are using two registers to store the address. Here I am indicating with code, move C. Code means what? C stands for code. Program memory, ROM is also called program memory because we are storing programs in that. And ROM is also called code memory because we are storing some codes, codes of static data or permanent data which is written once and used many times. So the codes of this static data is made available in a special part of ROM. That special part is called what? Lookup table. Okay. This will be storing the codes of some static data or permanent data. Okay. See here, what I'm mentioning here, move C. Move C means move code A comma at the rate of A plus DPTR. What is happening here, sir? The content available in a memory location whose address is given by these two registers, okay, that content will be loaded in A. Okay, whereas writing into this is not possible because it is what? ROM. Next thing is what? We are storing what? 7-segment codes in this particular part of that memory that is called lookup table. How to generate codes? So here segments are available using common cathode technique that is active high. If you want to glow A, you should assign 1 to that thing. If you want to glow B, you should assign 1. In this manner, we will be generating codes and they are stored in that thing. And we have seen the example of this thing. Okay. Move A comma DPTR, have loading this base address into DPTR, index into accumulator, and then combined, okay, A plus DPTR, this combined will be giving an address, effective address, pointing out to a memory location, this particular memory location, the content available in this will be loaded into A. So here in the instruction, I have mentioned move C, that means code available in this memory location will be loaded into A. So what is the code? If you draw it using active high logic, you will get 2D. So 2D will be loaded into A. So I think this is very clear. Okay. So if you have any doubts, please ask. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can message. Everyone, please, you need to react. If you have any doubts,